Hi everyone, today we are going to see about the continue and the break statement in the Python. We will see this with one example. Before that I will tell you what is continue and what is break. Continue is a statement. So far we have seen the for loop. With for loop itself I can tell you how to use the continue statement. Suppose in the for loop you have 10 number of statements, but you want to execute some 5 statements from 10 statements for a specific conditions. So there you can use continue. Suppose there is a list. In that list, under the for loop, there is 10 statement. From every list, from that list, if one item is coming, for the particular condition, if the item is getting true value, then it no need to iterate the rest of the following 10 sentence. Then you have to go for the continue over there. If you give the continue, then if the condition is true, then below the continue statements, whatever the statements are available, that will not be executed for the current iteration. So it will go for the next iteration. It is the use of the continue. Whereas break statement will terminate the iteration of the entire loop. That is the statement of the break. So continue will just continue for the next iteration, but break will entirely terminate the loop. This is the example, this is the meaning for the continue and the break statement. We will see with one example so that you will understand the continue and the break statement. Here I have given one list which is having apple, banana and cherry, and I have just give it into the for loop. Here I have given one if condition inside the for loop. When x is equal to banana, we have given break. Then I have given print x which is under the for loop. So it will check the condition. When this condition is true, then it will not execute the next statement, and also it will not go for the next iteration. It will terminate the loop entirely. So when here the first iteration, the x will come apple, then you when the x is equal to banana, it will check, it is a false. So this will not execute, then it will print the x where the apple will be printed. When the second iteration will come, the banana will come. So banana equal to banana, so if the condition is true, so it will execute break. So it will come out of the loop. So the banana also will not be printed and cherry also will not be printed. So only apple you will get it as a output. Whereas in continue statement, you have given this, I have taken the same example with continue also. Look at here this is done as continue. The same, first you will take the apple, and apple is not equal to banana, so it will go to the print x. So apple will be printed. Same, it is coming for a second iteration, banana will be equal to the banana. So the condition is true, so it will go for the continue. So continue statement will just skip the statement whatever is given after the continue for the current iteration only. So print x, if you have 10 number of statements also under this, it will skip the current iteration. So in this there is no print statement after the continue, because it will skip. So the banana will not be printed, but it will go for the next iteration. The third iteration, cherry will be given here in the fruit, and then it is cherry is not equal to banana, so then it will come to the print statement, then it will print the cherry. Here you will not get the banana as the output, instead you will get apple and cherry as the output. Let me run this two program and I will show you the output so you will understand that. So I am running the break program, Python break.py. So you can see the output. So only apple is printed, that terminated the for loop. So next continue. So here apple is printed and banana is not printed, then cherry is printed. Hope you understand the difference between the continue and the break statement. So far till now we have seen so many statements, so I am giving you one small assignment that you can try a printing of the tables, 2 table, 3 table, 5 table, n table, any table you can try it. I want the output as like 1 into 2 is equal to, suppose if it is a 2 table, 1 into 2 is equal to 2, 2 into 2 is equal to 4, something like that I want to get it. But the input should be get from the user for which number of table it is and till which number it has to be printed. So try it. We will see the output in next program. Thank you.